our presentation. You would like to talk about recovery and replication. You think it's two very important things, and logical replication is key. We think is key feature of Postgres 10, and how to do recovery when we include logical replication in our system. Our presentation is about problem. Okay, my name is Mikhail. It's Konstantin. All our experience mostly based on working at Avito. In Avito, Avito is like Craigslist. Do you know Craigslist? It's Russian Craigslist, and it's very big platform. Maybe it number two all over the world after Craigslist. I was one of the first developer programmer who start from scratch built Avito, and core part of platform Postgres databases was, and many other subsystem like search subsystem very close to Postgres and Postgres features. And of course Avito was started in 2008, and from the beginning we started using logical replication to solve scalability and scaling and integrate with search subsystem, where search subsystem was separated dedicated server, where Postgres dedicated with Postgres dedicated database, and content from and content from main master database was streamed to search system, and it was built through logical application, in that time it was built with Fontesty. Do you, someone know what is it? Yeah, Dmitry Fontaine, of course, knows. It still work in Avito, and our research we start our research to compare old-fashioned trigger-based replication. Will prove it for us as. And new features. We started when Postgres provide logical decoding, and since logical decoding, we start to investigate how we can do all our patterns in new conditions of inbuilt replication. Two words about Fontesty. It PGQ based system where core subsystem is Q and ticker. Ticker track snapshots, and Q is a lateral table with events and above this system, Landeist worker performs replicate events from queue, and for Landeist queue is like insert, update, deletes. If you compare it to today's Postgres, Ticker produce something like LSN in terms of architecture of streaming in building streaming, and queue is similar to write ahead log, where all events stored, and based on Landeist and PGQ, we in Avito realized many systems, not only replication, and it was my account. I started build storage system on Avito and use many features from SkyTools and PGQ. Now after research was finished, and we can see how we can switch our patterns, our schemas of replications and distributed data performing to new architecture based on built-in streaming. And on current architecture, we see that logical application based on write-ahead log is main difference between trigger-based application made by regular tables and triggers and built-in Postgres application. And now we will show most important cases, and Konstantin will show realization in commands, in script of how we can do it now in Postgres 10. Kostya, please.
Hello. As Michael say, that in Avito, with the help of logical replication, we have successfully solve problems of scaling of load, data streaming to search system, build our own implementation of persistent queue, the storage of each state of each row in our databases. Is the main customer of it is our data warehouse team, and also we implement inter-service communication through the logical replication, and as a result we have a large complex distributed system, and nothing happens for free, failures are happen, and you must be ready for it, because software and hardware failures are normal, and over the years, using logical replication, we have rethink a lot and implement our own add-ins and solutions. And now we want to show how to switch our experience from SkyTools PGQ, where the replication queue is a table, two new built-in replication in PostgreSQL 10 where the queue is walls. And there are four cases I want to tell about. First, reinitializing subscriber from another subscriber. And all our examples is open on GitHub. You can watch through all commands I will show. The infrastructure for this case is as following. You have a provider and two subscribers. We have two logical subscribers for redundancy purposes, because if you want to have no downtime, you won't duplicate every node. And when one node crashes, you switch your user queries to second node. But then you need to recreate second node. And how to do it? You can reinitialize it from your provider, but in our infrastructure, in some cases, it's not possible because we have an overloaded provider, or we have some logic intrigues on subscriber side. And this means then when we start to reinitialize, the estimated time of reinitializing will be too long because of triggers. Or even we don't have the source on provider because in our logical replication we have a derivative from our data. So for that purpose we do next. We reinitialize subscriber from another subscriber. First we need to resubscribe on our provider. Then we need to wait till our new subscriber position is visible on all subscriber, and then start pgdump. And after pgdump, we need to change our queue position according to destination and start replication. As a result, we have a new subscriber created from old one. Let's see how to do it with PostgreSQL 10 and built-in replication. First of all, we need to create replication slot for our new subscriber. We see this is Repka 2. We created it with the help of create slot. Next, we need to disable our subscription, and I tell you why. Currently, for tracking progress of logical replication, PG replication origin is used. It is a table in memory. Replication status, and it is dumped to disk with a checkpoint, and also the progress of replication is written to all files. But it's not transactional. Even if you open a repeatable read transaction and twice try to get the value of PG replication origin, you can get different results. That's why we need to disable our logical replication, and only then we get the value of replication origin, and then we start PG dumping it. We must remember PG replication origin value. Then we start PG dump, and there is another feature. We need use option no subscriptions. This option is needed because currently PG dump subscription with not connected. It means that after restoring this dump, your subscriber will be unlinked to your provider. So there will no data about tables. And this means that if you try to connect your restored subscriber to provider, your logical replication slot will be consumed to dev null. And to start consuming it, you need to run refresh publication command. But there will be a time period during which your data will be consumed to dev null, and it will be a crash. So that means that we need dump subscription, and then we will create it manually. So after starting dump, we can enable our subscription. And we can see that enable our active subscriber. We see that one slot is active and another one not active. I want to highlight that when we dump, the status of both subscribers was equal. And then after we turn on active one subscriber alive, the log sequence number position is greater than on inactive, which we reinitializing. It means that some actions is happens and our logical replication streams some changes to our active subscriber. Then we create manually subscription with options enabled false, but creating slot false and copy data false. We not need to initialize it because we start dumping on previous step. After this, we need to switch to move our log sequence number on restored subscriber with the help of command pg replication origin advance, and we use log sequence number we have logged on first step when we stop logical replication. Then we check that we have successfully moved our log pg replication origin on reinitialized subscriber. And after this, we can enable our logical replication. As a result, we have reinitialized subscriber from another subscriber with the help of pgdump. And also we can recheck the status, replication origin status on both subscribers and see that they are equal. Second case. Second case, undo, recovery on the destination side. The infrastructure for this case is as follows. We have provider, the source of our logical replication, provider standby, and logical subscriber. And in this case, imagine that the position of your subscriber may be in future in relation to your standby provider standby. I want to mention one aspect of our infrastructure. We use logical and streaming replication in asynchronous mode because synchronous mode may not couple with real huge OTP load. So all cases I tell about is set up in asynchronous mode. So, and when your logical subscriber when provider standby is fallen behind your logical subscriber, it can happen due to several reasons, such as overloaded standby, some queries on standby which prevents applying your wall, and so on. In this case, when your source of your logical replication is crashes and you promoting to your standby, your replica is in future, logical replica is in future. And for this case, in a for this purpose, in Avito, we developed undo framework. It looks like an audit log where we write down with the help of triggers all opposite actions for insert, write, delete, for update, another update, for delete, insert. And then we check our position of promoted provider and apply undo to position of our provider. After this, we can enable our logical replication. First of all, let's see on structure at structure of our undo log table. On undo log table, we store log sequence number, the name of schema, name of table, undo command, command data for update it's needed, and identity field. So let's see how to implement it on PostgreSQL 10. First of all, before promotion your standby provider standby, you need to write down your log sequence number of your standby. Next, it's very important before promotion your standby, don't turn on your client queries, because if you after promotion run some user queries on your promoted standby, this data will not be replicated to your logical subscriber. Before, after promotion, you need to create logical replication slot. And after this, you can run some user queries on your promoted standby. Third, after this, we can check for our case that we have some records in our undo log, which is in future in relation to our new promoted provider standby, the source of our replication. Also, we check can check our log sequence number on subscriber and see that it is also in future in relation to our source of our logical replication. And then we run undo command and see that it is successfully applies. And I forget to mention that also on this link you can find our implementation of undo for logical replication in PostgreSQL 10, and also on our GitHub you can find our implementation for undo for SkyTools. Next, after this we can enable our logical replication, but there is one more aspect. We get LSN for our undo records in trigger with the help of PG replication origin session progress. And in trigger,
in the last slide, previous slide, like if the undo apply gets failed due to some reason, how will you reconstruct it?
You can reinitialize your logical subscriber from the source, but when we have a failover, we need to have minimal downtime, and applying of undo takes for about few seconds. If there will be some error, so it will be a long crash, and we try to reinitialize it from provider. Yes. We don't during applying of undo we don't move client queries on our production promoted provider, so we turn on client traffic only after successful recovery procedure. So it consists of promoting of our source and then apply and undo. In our infrastructure, we all automated. In our auto failover, we implement also apply and undo. So we detect the crash, promote and apply automatically in our infrastructure. So you can do the same with our undo. Next. And the final step of our failover is switching DNS. So we switch DNS for user queries only after applying undo. So what I want to say. In trigger, when we write down undo records, we can see only log sequence number only from previous changes for our logical replication. And it is another aspect of our undo that here is like master LSN log sequence number standby. So at master we at position 15th on standby. Standby is fallen behind on 8, and the logical subscriber is on the same state as master. But because we can see in trigger only previous LSN, data changes which on master with LSN number 5th, we have only 12 previous section from imagine with previous LSN log sequence number. So when we have a crash on our provider, promote to our standby, then we need to apply undo to all undo records that is equal to highest position of log sequence number of our new source or greater than its highest position. And
this ratio is 8 to 5, not 2 to 8. Because 8 was based on, because 8 was, 5 was based on LSM 8.
Another thing I want to tell you about Undo. There can be one infrastructure such as when you have a few sources and one destination, and you need to mark records from one source with the name of this source and another second source with second source Undo records. Because when you have a failure of one source, you need to apply Undo records only for this source. And we can do this with following query. We can get the name of subscription from PG state subscription with the filter on PG backend PID or from current PID. And there is now no possibility on publication site to find out who consumes your slots. For this purpose, we suggest to have an external list with links between provider and subscriber, and to have a special format name for subscriptions, which will link to your source. Third, redo. Reposition source, so it's a crash on subscriber. The infrastructure is the following. You have a provider of your logical replication. Then you have a logical replication to your subscriber. And subscriber have a binary standby. So there are two kind of types of replication. Between provider and subscriber, it's logical replication. And between subscriber and its standby, it's binary replication. And when you have a crash of your subscriber, logical subscriber master, in this case, your subscriber standby can be following behind provider. And after promotion of your subscriber standby, you need to change the queue position according to your new destination. And only after this, you can start replaying the logical replication. Everything I tell, we do with Sky tools, and now it is how to do it in PostgreSQL 10. And for this purpose, we manually create a logical slot for our subscriber standby. And then we need to consume it manually with SQL command pg logical slot get binary changes. So let's see. First, we manually create slot and see that nobody consume it. It's not active. Then we can add some changes on our provider and see that replication logical consumer successfully consumed it. Also, we can check that logical consumer standby successfully replayed also these changes. And only after this, we need to consume our manually get changes from our manually created slot to position. We see we lock down on step three. So we manually move our manually created slot, check that we have successfully moved it, and then emulate a delay of our subscriber standby. We edit PG HBA conf and revoke access. So then we made some new changes and see that logical subscriber have successfully received them, and subscriber standby don't receive these changes. we emulate subscriber crashed, just turn off subscribers master. Subscriber standby is still falling behind. Then we need to drop replication slot for our crashed subscriber, logical subscriber. Because if you not drop this slot, when you promote your subscriber, it will consume the slot, provide the standby, promoted provider standby will consume wrong slot, and there will be a gap in your data, and it also be data corruption. This is why we drop slot for our crashed subscriber master, check that we have successfully dropped it, and then we check our PG replication origin status of our subscriber standby, and sync manually created slot to this LSN. So then we check that promoted subscriber standby is still falling behind. We don't promote it, it's still standby. Then we promote it, see in log errors that there is no replication slot because we have dropped it. Then we, so it's still falling behind, and alter our subscription, switch it to manually created slot. And after this, we see that our promoted subscriber successfully consumed changes from our slot. So slot is consumed, replication origin status on subscriber changed, and we see changes on our promoted subscriber. I want to highlight the algorithm of consuming manually created slot. Now it's not easy. We need to check position on provider on from active slot. Then we need check PG replication origin on subscriber, which matches to this position, and wait till PG replication origin from subscriber will be applied on subscriber standby. And only after this, you can move your manually created logical slot on provider to position from step one. And fourth case, redo two, crash on provider side. The infrastructure for this case is following. You have a provider, provider standby, and logical subscriber. And there can be another situation when your logical subscriber is falling behind provider standby. It can happen by design, because on provider you have a lot of backends that make some changes, and only one backend apply changes for logical replication on logical subscriber. Or there can be some queries that locks relation to which lock logical replication relations. So for many reasons, your logical subscriber can fall behind your provider standby. And if your provider master fails, crashes, and you promote into your provider standby, there's now no any possibility to get changes, deliver changes from your promoted provider to subscriber, because you can't create logical replication slot on your standby. Logical replication slot is not replicated with the help of binary replication. And imagine if you have an infrastructure such as when you on subscriber create some business logic and all changes from logical replication, for example, all states of records of replicated tables, you move to another table. And in this case, you will no possibility to get some states of your records. So this problem we face in Avito with this problem, but with SkyTools it works by design. We don't do anything with it. A lot of Russian IT companies face the same problem. One of the largest bank, Tinkoff Bank, largest company, Yandex, face the same problem. And it is a blocker for production usage of logical replication in some systems. Yes, even now we can do something. We will tell about it later. we see a lot of activity in PostgreSQL community about failover slots and some other activities, and we are hoping to see a solution for this problem in future releases. But now, even now, we will suggest something later. Now let's make some conclusions. Green OK means that with Sky tools, everything we do even now in our infrastructure, almost everything we can do in PostgreSQL 10. Let's see our proposal list to make it more comfortable. First, make a PG replication origin transactional or pin it to snapshot. It will make you easier to dump your subscriber. If PG replication origin be transactional, you need not to stop your logical replication to create a copy of your subscriber. Second, dump the state of logical replication with PG dump, or to create some kind of option to enable it. Third, implement some kind logical undo, or create some kind of SQL API to implement it. The fourth, track the progress of consuming logical slot on subscriber from provider. Provider start LSN to make it easier to implement redo case, the algorithm of consuming manually created replication, logical replication slot. Fifth, compare LSN between subscriber and provider. In SkyTools, it is serial consumer. We need to raise error when the state on subscriber not matches your provider. For example, when your provider or subscriber in future or in the past. Six, function to move slot on provider. Currently, we consume slot, so we get changes, but we need some kind of function just to move slot, and we find this stored procedure in release notes in PostgreSQL 10, PG replication slot advance. 11, sorry. Seventh, logical slot on standby. So it's a blocker for production usage. But Misha suggests a solution how to do it now.
I suggest solution that we just need to get not this picture, but switch it to our case with undo. We have to get some mechanism to get standby always behind logical subscriber. For example, for binary replication, cascading replication. Then, if we have cascading replication, we guarantee that one is forward to another. But when we have one binary replication and one logical, now we can simple do some cascade between it. But if we do binary replication, for example, with archive command, then we can in restore command only consumed write ahead logs according to LSN we consumed on subscriber of logical application.
Some kind of throttling.
And in this case, our standby would be always in the past according to logical subscriber. Or for example, now already we got some option in recovery conf. It's a recovery target. For example, and we can set recovery target to some LSN, but if we can imagine some more advanced behavior of recovery process, which can recover to some LSN and then update LSN according to some script maybe. And it's our view to problem, but from another side to problem of failover slots and how we can synchronize all relation between nodes, physical application and logical application. Okay.
And also. In Avito, we implement event tracking with the help of logical replication. And in PostgreSQL 10, you can do it with proxy table or can use PG logical emit message procedure and implement your own logical decoder. So unlocked table don't replicate it by design, but when we use logical replication, trigger-based logical replication, we often use unlocked tables, and because we have two logical copies for each node, and we don't need to write them to all files, and sequences also not replicated in PostgreSQL 10 replication. In conclusion, I want to say that this research was made, we start this research and it was made by Michael Turin, our colleague Sergey Bouladian and me. And we start do it when PostgreSQL Alpha was released. And many thanks to Stas Kelvich from PostgreSQL for Professional for reviewing and discussing our solutions. We want to say that logical replication built-in is very huge step forward. It is very cool feature. It is very easy to set up. Just create a subscriber, provider, some table, and it works like magic. But we need this talk to highlight the problems Russian PostgreSQL community faced. And I suppose Worldwide PostgreSQL community face the same problems, and we're all hoping that our research will help to resolve these problems, and we are hoping to find out some solutions in future PostgreSQL releases. Thank you for your attention. Questions are welcome.